so as you see, I had one of these ugly lampshades in my apartment, and I wanted to upgrade it, make it look something a little bit prettier. So in order for me to do that, I went online and I looked at how other people did, because I wanted a drum shade. And after a couple of tries, wasn't really great the first try, but I can give you some information on that. To create a new lampshade that's out of a regular lampshade, so I can have a drum. You could probably use any kind that you would want to. And I happened to find this lampshade at Pottery Barn on sale for $29. And it has a little, I don't know what you would want to call this, but this made it even a little bit more of a nicer design than if one was inside further. And what you're gonna do is, I'm gonna figure out how wide and deep of a lampshade that you want. And then you're going to make a stencil of what's inside this parameter. So you could, I could have made it so that it fit perfectly snug, which I had tried on the first one. I didn't like it because of the ability of getting it in there, because I happened to just break my first covering, but that's what's so nice about, you first want to make your template, because that way, once you cut it out, you can make sure how it's going to fit. So if you really want this to be a little bit more snug, this is the best way to go, so that you don't mess it up and cut it too big or make it too small, and then you have a big mess on your hand. So I made a little template like this, made it smaller so that I wanted a little bit of light to come around the perimeter. Put that aside. Go down to your hardware store. This is a fluorescent cover. It is, let's see if it has anything. It's 22 by 22. You get one of these. I would suggest to buy two. This is my third one. I had to go back because my one that I bought on my first try, which is this template, it breaks very easily if you're not careful. And you're going to put your template on this flat side, and you're going to trace around the outer edge with any kind of marker. Now, I used a blue marker, and the blue marker kind of stayed there. It wouldn't come off, so I ended up having to use a sandpaper to get that black line off the edge of it, so it wouldn't show up when the light was on. So you might try to find something else that wouldn't be so permanent. So there's a little fluid thing to do. So once you trace it out on the plastic, then you're going to cut it. So once you trace it out, you can take masking tape and you're going to cover that line that you're going to cut. Now, I saw online they used really heavy scissors. Well, I tried that on a little piece just to see what happened, and it just shattered this plastic. So I came up with a much better plan, and that was using one of these nice blades, put it on a surface cover that so that you know I'm gonna scorn this, and you wanna definitely put it on something that if you slip, you know, you don't cut into a table or whatever. And I just took a little bit of time and I just kept scorning over and over and over until it started making a crackling sound. So you don't have to penetrate this completely down. You just really want to get a nice round scorn around here, and I'm probably pronouncing that right, wrong. So once you get that done, I could take my fingers and lightly snap it the opposite direction from where the cut was in, and it broke off really pretty clear. Now you gotta be very careful, and you wanna wear glasses, because this stuff does splinter off into little pieces and it is very sharp. And you'll be able to get this completely round, and you wanna be very careful because you don't wanna crack like this happened. Once I had gotten that all done, I took a little bit of sandpaper, just kinda rounded off the edges a little bit. Then I took a drill, don't have it, but it's like a little drill, and I just slowly made the circular hole in here because I certainly didn't want to shatter it doing it that. Make sure you support it very well while you're doing your hole. And this is also, I just laid this on top when I had my lamp in their place where I wanted it, and I took a pin inside and marked it so that I knew where to put the hole. So once you get that all done, then you want to take and get a really nice linen. And it was like a dollar or something to get a yard. So I got linen, because I didn't want to see that plastic because I think it's ugly. And I Mod Podge that linen to the plastic. And it gives it a nice texture, plus it doesn't look like plastic anymore. And when you do that, and you do Mod Podge, good old stuff. This one is matte. I wasn't sure what the clear would do, and so I did the matte. So you basically just see the fabric on this. You want to start from the center out and a little at a time. That way you can stretch the fabric and not get any wrinkles in it. Do it all the way to the edge. I let that dry. Then I cut all the extras off. And then you want to go and line it. And this is just, it was in a fabric store. I guess you would call this finish. It's where all the ribbons were. And this is cotton. And so basically I just cut it to what I knew for the width of it, laid it on top like this, and I Mod Podged it all the way around to give that nice finished look on the lamp. Once that's all done, now you want to be able to send this to the fixture, and this is the rod. This is actually a lamp rod. I got this at Cliff's Hardware Store, which sells pieces so that you can create your own lamps. They all come in different sizes, so I did try different ones. This was too long because it showed the light bulbs. This was just the right size. You also have to remember that there's that, you want to bring it up high enough to cover it, but leave enough gaps so that some light comes through. And this is a little coupling that also comes so that this is where this part will attach to the normal place that you would have screwed the light in. So, you know, you would normally do this and screw it in. But this, I screw that in, then I screw this in, and I have a washer. But it's all sold in the same place where all of this came for lamp, creating your own lamps. So the washer here is so that when I screw this onto here, I can get a really nice tight fit so that the shade here doesn't flop around so much. And luckily for the shade that I bought, this will also stabilize that. So that's a pretty much an easy way to do a lamp. It took me probably about an hour and a half to do, top 2 hours the most. The most time-consuming was making the pattern and cutting out the plastic, and that's why I say you should buy two, because if you break it, you know what to do for the second one. And they're not too expensive. I think it was like $7 or $8 for that sheet. I only spent about a dollar for the trimming. Was almost about $2 for the fabric. This rod was $2.80. We're talking about another $1.50, and that was like 25 cents, and almost thirty dollars for the lampshade. So for about a little over $40, I was able to make a lampshade, which I will show you in just a few moments. So once you get all your stuff together, you can pretty much go, and you'll come up with this beautiful lamp that I'm going to show
okay.
you.
Okay, hopefully you can see all this, but since I'm doing this by myself, it's a little hard to see if I got this all right. So here's the rod. Here I'm going to attach it to the fixture. And these are LED lights, and one's fluorescent. I certainly would not put regular bulbs in here because I would think it gets a little bit too hot. That would be my suggestion. But you don't want to make sure there's enough up there. Get it nice and snug. I readjust this until I got it to where I felt that it looked like the best. Here here's my lampshade. Now, I had tried the plastic covering underneath, but because it is got a little bit of weight, it gets a little bit of a wobble. I didn't like that look, and because of that harp in there, I guess if that's what you want to call it, supports it even better and even gives it a little bit more of a nicer texture, having that three spike down there. So then we're just going to feed this right through the hole that I had drilled in. And you can always buy new fiddles that look nicer than the one that came with it. And you just screw that in like that. And voila! There you have your light. Guess I can stay up here. So, got a little bit of a gap here, got a little bit of gap inside, and looks pretty good. A lot better than the old one up there. Turn on the light for you. Voila! There you go. A brand new lampshade for your ceiling. Well, there you go. Turn off the lights so that you can see a little bit better. So there you go with a handmade, almost handmade, drum lampshade for your living space. Much prettier than the old 1960s glass circular shade or square, whichever you have. Very easy to do. And I hope you enjoy this video, and it was pretty easy in me explaining to you how I created this one. And I hope that you take the time to try to make your own and create your own style for your own room. And thank you so much for watching this video, and take care and enjoy life. Goodbye.